Good morning, students. How are you all doing? Let me introduce myself. This is Ampati. SA Biosense. Talking for the page of Mani Pippa. Mandal Vedal Pali. Testing Marangal Alpha.
Today, we are going to discuss about the nerve tissue, which is one of the animal tissue. Observe this video. If you put your fingers in a glass of hot water, how do you feel? Similarly, how do you feel when you put your hands in cold ice cubes? How would you know if the water is hot or cold? If you put your leg on a sharp-edged stone while walking, how will you feel? Coldness, heat, pain, how do you feel them? How do you perceive these? The feelings like the above situations are because of specialized mechanism in our body. It is called the nervous system. The nervous system consists of nerve tissue. Nervous tissue is found in the brain, spinal cord and nerves. Here you can examine the brain and the nerves that originate from it, the spinal cord and the nerves that originate from it. Nerve tissue is mainly composed of nerve cells and glial cells. Nerve cells are called neurons. Neurons are termed as the structural and functional unit of the nervous system. Nerve cells collect information from a variety of sense organs, generate electrical impulses, and deliver this information to the brain in the form of electrical impulses, as well as convey the commands generated by the brain to various affected organs through the nerves in the form of electrical impulses. Now let us do a task to examine the nerve cell. Let us take a permanent slide of a nerve cell that is present in our laboratory and examine it under a compound microscope. You can see nerve cells and glial cells here. Now, two neurons or nerve cells in the nervous system have the same appearance. Nerve cells do not have the ability to generate if lost accidentally. Cells of the nervous system are highly specialized for transmitting the stimulus rapidly from one place to another within the body. You can observe glial cells here. Glial cells are generally smaller than neurons and are more in number than nerve cells in the brain. Unlike neurons, they continue to divide throughout life. They have the ability to regenerate. These are the supporting and non-conducting cells that provide a micro-environment suitable for neuronal activity. Some glial cells are phagocytic and protect against bacterial invasion, while others provide nutrients by binding blood vessels to the neurons. Now let us look at the nerve cell structure. We can identify three distinct parts in nerve cells. They are: one is cyton or soma or cell body. Second one is dendrites. Third one is axon that end with axon terminals. The cell body. The cell body is irregular or polyhedral in shape. Cell body or cyton has a large nucleus in the cytoplasm. Cytoplasm contains a granular structure called nissles or tigrad granules, which contain a group of ribosomes for protein synthesis. Second one is dendrite. There are some projections arising from the cell body. These are called dendrite. They are sharp, branched, more in number. The functions of dendrites are to receive information from other neurons and sense organs and to transfer the information to the soma of the neuron. Third one is axon. One projection of the cyton is somewhat longer than the remaining projections. This is called an axon. Some nerve cells have axon covered sheath like structures. This sheath is called myelin sheath. The myelin sheath is made up of Schwann cells and mainly consists of fatty materials. Here you can observe Schwann cells secreting myelin sheath around the axon. This sheath is interrupted at regular intervals, called nodes of Ranvier. The nodes of Ranvier facilitate the rapid conduction of nerve impulses along the axon. We can see small swellings at the terminal ends of the axon. These are called axon terminals. Next, synapse. Axon terminals of a nerve cell are connected with the dendrites of a nearby nerve cell to form a web-like structures throughout the body. The narrow space where the terminals of nerve cells meet the dendrites of another nerve cell is called a synapse. It acts as a structural gap and a functional bridge. Synapse is the region where information from one neuron is transmitted or related to another neuron. The nervous system consists of the brain, spinal cord, and nerve cells. Nerve cells or neurons are structural and functional units of the nervous system or nervous tissue. Nerve cells do not have the ability to regenerate like other cells. Nerve cells can receive and analyze information and send information to various parts in the form of electrical impulses. The nerve cell consists of three main parts. One is cell body or cyton, second one is dendrites, third one is axon. Large nucleus is present in cytoplasm of cell body. It also contains small granular structures called Nissl's granules. Axon is surrounded by myelin sheath. Myelin sheaths are interrupted at regular intervals called Ranvier nodes. Axon terminals of one nerve cell meet with the dendrites of another nerve cell by narrow gap called synapse. Evaluation. Describe the structure of nerve cell. What is the importance of nodes of Ranvier in axon? What is synapse? Write down difference between nerve cells and glial cells. Draw the well-labeled diagram of the nerve cell.